The mainstream media wants to cancel her. Nancy Pelosi wants to expel her. But she's still standing. Congresswoman Marjorie Taylor Greene, Republican of Georgia. Welcome back to Newsmax. How you holding up? You're terrific. How are you? Good evening.
I'm doing well, Greg. How are you doing?
I'm all right. But look, once again, Twitter is out to get you. You tweeted something very beautiful, I think, for Easter. Let's put it up on the screen. He is risen. He is risen. Christ has risen. You'll be surprised. Maybe you won't be. But how little talk there was about Christ in public circles on Easter. More about jelly beans and that kind of junk. Did this tweet get you in trouble or not? Because I hear that, well, what happened after this?
So I tweeted that Easter message, he is risen, happy Easter. I also had retweeted a tweet about abortion. And then I got suspended for 12 hours on Twitter with no explanation, received the email, received the notification that I was suspended on Twitter. And then later in the day, Twitter admit that they made an error once again. So I got suspended for 12 hours for the second time in a matter of weeks on this platform that has spent hundreds of millions of dollars on their platform, on their technology. But yet they somehow keep making little mistakes and suspending me.
Well, let's take a look at the statement. Yeah, it seemed coincidence. I don't think so. But let's take a look. Oh, my gosh. Lots of words there. Same statement on April 4th and on March 19th. The combination of technology, blah, 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 blah. This action has been reversed and your account has been reinstated. What did you do on March 19th? What did you do? What did they say? What happened on March 19th?
That happened to be the same day that Democrat from California, Representative Gomez, introduced his resolution to expel me from Congress for doing absolutely nothing wrong. You see, these people can't even file an ethics complaint on me, but they are just so offended that I won't back down from stopping what they're trying to do. And I do it. I go on the floor. I call for roll call vote to put Congress on record for voting, and they just can't take it. They'd love to pass their bills through the dark of the night, and they're very offended by that. They're just offended by my conservative values and my willingness to call them out and speak the truth. So Twitter apparently doesn't like it either, which I really could care less, because, you know, I think once President Trump launches his social media platform, most people will be done with Twitter, and then it'll just be one big, I guess, leftist, woke, progressive chat room where they just all virtue signal to themselves about how voting or showing IDs is racist or something ridiculous like that.
Well, you know what, though? I still think we got to fight in that forum. I've gone back and forth on this myself, and I think we've got to present our ideas even when the feedback is hostile. So think about that, please. But I will point out that Twitter is strangely tolerant of far-left, horrible nonsense. Louis Farrakhan, let's go ahead and put this tweet up, shall we? Louis Farrakhan, thoroughly and completely unmasking the satanic, I can't even say this. This is totally anti-Semitic. So strange. But this this gets liked on Twitter and retweeted, and no problem. Let's have a look at another one. Let's see, who's this guy? One of the leaders in Iran. Holocaust is an event whose reality is uncertain. If it has happened, it's uncertain how it has happened. This is the kind of stuff that is tolerated on Twitter. But happy Easter somehow lands you, Congresswoman, in Twitter jail. How strange is that? By the way, I'd love to get your take on the All-Star Game situation. You're from Georgia. It has now been designated. It will take place in Denver. Seems crazy. Seems unnecessary. Your thoughts overall?
My thoughts overall are this. When Major League Baseball wants to stop requiring identification to pick up tickets at the will call window, then we can have a conversation about showing an ID to vote. When Delta wants to stop requiring people to show an ID to fly on their airline, then we can have a conversation about showing ID to vote. When Coca-Cola wants to change the laws in our country where people don't have to show ID to buy their alcoholic beverages, then we can have a conversation about showing ID to vote. I have a strong opinion on this, and it is not racist to require people to have an ID to vote. It's very racist to assume that Black people are not intelligent enough to be able to get an ID to vote. So I think the Democrats are the ones that are definitely being the racist in this situation. They're looking down on Black voters, and so are these very rich CEOs of these very successful corporations.
By the way, boycotting. Are you thinking about that? I personally have stopped drinking Coke. Personally, I'm not calling for a boycott. It's not good for you anyway. But I did remember what they did, their nasty little statement. And I said, you know what? I'm done with that. What do you think of boycotts? The president, President Trump, basically endorsed one the other day and said conservatives have to get their act together when it comes to that stuff.
Well, I'm a big believer that you're in control of your money, and where you spend it is definitely your business. And if we want to, we should be doing everything we can to stop these corporations and what I call corporate communism. And that's exactly what it is. It's corporate communism. It's these corporations pushing their leftist ideology onto their employees and onto their customers. And that's just flat out wrong. And so, yeah, I'm a believer. And if people don't like a company's policies, if you don't like the way you're being treated, then you can take your dollars elsewhere. So I support people in doing that. But I also think that business is important, and businesses should focus on one thing only, and that's their customers.
Yeah, not virtue signaling and not all that other stuff. I think they're up to some sort of regulatory things, and they have an international audience that they sometimes worry about as well as American. So, hey, Marjorie Taylor Greene, you're amazing. Thank you for coming back. Come back anytime. Congresswoman from Georgia, Republican, to be continued, and thank you.
Thank you, Greg.
All right, all the best.
Hey, I'm Rob Finnerty. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please join the conversation in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe, too. Hit the bell icon to be alerted to breaking news. And remember, there's a whole lot more on Newsmax TV, America's fastest growing cable news network. Newsmax TV, where real news for real people.